Hello and welcome to our next module in Java. What you've seen so far is an introduction to Java and the features of Java. Coming up next is an actual program in Java. This is the first program that we're going to look at, and it's called the Hello World program. A Hello World program is simply a program that displays the text Hello World on the screen. And typically, whenever you learn a new programming language, the standard introductory program to that language is the Hello World program that uses the syntax of that language to print the text Hello World on the screen. All right, so time to look at the Java's Hello World program, which is our first program in a very matrixy fashion. Now, as you can see, the syntax of Java is very similar to that of C++. So those of you who are familiar with C++ from your previous semester, good for you. But for others, we'll go over this program word by word. First, the first line is kind of the class Hello World. This is a line that says that this is going to be a class called Hello World. Now, as you know, Java is object oriented, which means almost all your programs are going to have classes. And almost everything is going to be part of a class. So the next line here is public static void main string args, which is essentially your main method where the execution begins. Now in Java, the main method is always a part of a class. The main method in this case is a part of a class called Hello World. And then the third line is the only line in the main method that does a magical job of printing the text Hello World on the screen, which is system.out.println. Alright, so this is the program in brief. Let's look at it word by word. The first word is a keyword called class. Now, as I said, all your programs, almost all of them, will have a class definition in them. And to actually start defining a class, you have to use the keyword class. And this is followed by the class name. And then you have opening and closing curly braces. And everything that's a part of these curly braces is a part of the class definition. So here is my keyword class. The name of my class here is Hello World. Now the name of the class could be anything that you want, but typically you should make it something relevant to the program. Now one of the conventions for using class names in Java is camel case. The camel case convention means that the first letter of every word in the class name is capitalized. Here my class name has two words, Hello and World, so H and W are capital. So this is my class name. Now, how do you actually save this program? Every Java program has an extension of Java. So all your Java files are going to be something.java. But what will that something be? You cannot save this file as anything you like. The name of the file has to be the same name as that of the class in which the main method resides. In this case, the main is a part of a class called Hello World, which is why the name of this file has to be helloworld.java. Many students, after a semester full of programming, forget this rule, and then when it comes to the final practicals, they panic because their program refuses to compile. The simple mistake they've made is not saved it correctly. So every time, the first time your program refuses to compile, check if you've saved it correctly. It has to be the same name as that of the class in which you've written your main method. All right. So that's your Hello World. Let's move on to the next line. The next line is public static void main string args. Now this, as I said, is a part of this class called Hello World. Public static and void, the first three words of this line are used to describe the main method. You think of them as adjectives to the main method. The main method is public, the main method is static, and the main method is void. Now let's look at these three adjectives one by one. The first adjective you have is a keyword called public. Now whenever you have a class has members. And when you say members, you mean data members and methods. By the way, when I say methods in Java, it means functions of C++. In Java, you call the functions methods. So classes have members, and members could either be data members like string, name, int, marks, and so on. And they can have methods like compute, marks, whatever. All right. Now, in this case, this class does not have any data member. It has only one method, which is main. Now, whenever a class has members, there are rules on who can actually access this member. Whenever you make something public, everything, every code outside the class and code within the class can access the member. But when you make a method or a member private, that means only members of the class can access this particular member. Now, when you run the program, what really happens? When you try to run the program, the JVM or the Java Virtual Machine looks for the main method. And then once it finds the main method, it starts executing the lines of the main method. Now, JVM is something that is outside the class. You want something outside the class to access a member that is a part of the class. In that case, you have to make that member public. So the main is invoked by JVM, which is outside the class, which is why the main is public. All right, let's move on to the next adjective of the main, which is static. Now, this is a little challenging to understand at this stage, but anyway, let's give it a shot. Now, whenever you have a class, typically you also have an object and you actually work on objects. You create an object, you invoke the data members and methods using the object. However, there are times when you don't create an object and you directly use the members of the class from the class without creating an object. In that case, you make that member static because you're not going to create objects of the class to access that member. You're directly going to use this from the class. The main is invoked without creating objects, which is why the main is static. Now, as I said, we'll have a separate module to understand what static is. For now, just remember that you don't create objects, which is why the main is static. And the next adjective is void. The main is void. Now, whenever you have a method might return something. For example, if you write a method to add two numbers, you would give it two numbers and the method would return a number. So a method would have a return type and that would be number or an integer or a floating or something like that. However, if the method does not return anything, then the return type of the method is said to be void, which simply means nothingness in English. The method does not return anything. Now, the main is one method that does not return anything, which is why its return type is void. All right. And the next you have is a keyword main with round brackets, which says this is the main method. Start executing from here. Now, within brackets, within the round brackets after the main method, you have something called a string bracket args. What is this? This is a formal parameter to the main method. And this is a string array called args. And why do we use it? Now, any interesting program would want to take input from the user. How do you actually take input from the user? Once the program starts executing, the program asks the user to enter two numbers or to enter a name or to enter the input that the program thinks is relevant. However, another way to give input to the program is that the user already knows what the program expects as input. So when the user gives the command to run the program, along with the command, the user passes in what the user knows that the program expects as input. So when you give the command to run the program, along with that command on the command line, you give it input. And this input goes and gets stored in this string array called args. If you don't give that input, it does not get stored in this array. But if you do give an input, it gets stored in this array. And this input is given along with the command line, which is why this input is called command line arguments. And this string array is used to store command line arguments if they are passed. Now, in this hello world program, I'm not passing in any command line arguments, which is why this array remains empty. So string args is an array of strings used to store command line arguments if there are any. All right. So that was your public, static, void, main. Let's move on to the only line within the main method. So as you see, after the main, you have opening and closing curly braces. And now you have something within this main method, which is the only line, which is system.out.println. Now, system.out.println is used to print things on the screen. This is similar to your cout statement from C++. Whenever you want to print something on the screen, use system.out.println. Now one of the great parts of Java is that it has an awesome inbuilt library. There are so many classes that you can do very cool things using this inbuilt library. Now, system is a class that is already present in an inbuilt library. That means when you download and install Java, somewhere on your computer, there is a class called system and you can use it. And out is something called as an output stream. It streams things to the output. And println is the name of a method. How do you know that? Because after println, you have opening and closing round brackets. Typically, after a word, whenever you have an opening and closing round brackets, it's a good guess that this is a method. So system is an inbuilt class, out is an output stream, and println is a method. And whenever you give anything in the parameters to the method, it will print it on the screen. So to print anything on the screen, use system.out.println. In this case, we want to print hello world on the screen, and hello world is a string, which is why I put it within double quotes, and this gets printed on the screen. So this is my output statement. And finally, I have a little semicolon. Most students again tend to forget this, but always remember, all Java statements end with a semicolon. Make it a habit to write a semicolon after all your statements. Teachers have an extremely bad habit of cutting marks when the semicolon is not present, and you tend to lose a lot of marks because of that. So semicolon is a must. That's your Hello World program in all its glory. Let's quickly look at what we just saw. Class is a keyword class to define a class. Hello World is a name of the class in this case, and everything within this class, everything in this program is actually a part of this class called Hello World. It is camel cased, and the main method is a part of this class, which is why the name of this file has to be helloworld.java. Next line is the main method. Public, static, and void are kind of adjectives to the main method. The main method is public because it is invoked by something that is outside the class. The main method is static because you don't create objects to actually invoke the main method. The main method is void because it does not return anything. And then you have the keyword main with opening and closing round brackets with a string array called args in it, which is used to store command line arguments. And after that, within the main method, you have a system.out.println, which is the command used to print things on the screen. Whatever you pass within the round brackets gets printed on the screen. And lastly, do not forget your semicolons. So this is the Hello World program. Now, some of you might be thinking that, this is a little complicated. It's got a lot of keywords and it looks difficult. And how the hell will I ever get down to programming Java? But my genius advice, don't get scared. Take it step by step. Take the first step of downloading and installing Java on your computer. And then, even if you didn't understand a lot of this Hello World program, it's all right. Copy it on that computer, learn how to compile a Java program, how to run the Java program, and see Hello World printed on the screen and feel very happy about executing your first Java program. And then move on, use your C++ knowledge to fiddle around in Java, because C++ is very similar to Java, and that was one of the great advantages of Java, that C++ programmers could easily migrate to Java. So use your C++ knowledge, and hopefully you remember something from your SEM1, right? Remember variables, initialize variables, and print them on the screen using the system.out.println. Create if statements, write for loops, while loops, whatever you remember. The best way to get over the fear of programming or this unfamiliarity you feel with the syntax is to actually sit down and write a lot of programs. So good luck with that. And in this module, we are going to see a lot of programs which you can practice.